Hi guys, welcome on my channel Crochet with Joanna. Today I'm going to show you how to crochet this beautiful doily. This doily we can make in different sizes by repeating the pattern. Few years ago on my channel I recorded the video how to crochet the smaller version for this pattern, and basically this is best viewing video on my channel. I had lots of views, about 1.4 million views so far, lots of positive comments, so I decided to make this project bigger because lots of you like this pattern and probably would make the bigger version as well. So my project in this size measure about 27 inches in diameter. If you would like to make this project even bigger, you have to repeat the pattern after the fans to another fans without the last one round, of course. And for this project I am using crochet hook size 1.75 mm and cotton thread in size 10. For white color I used a little bit more than 50 gram, and for the salmon color I used a little bit less than 50 gram. So whole project in this size should be done by using only 100 gram of the cotton thread. So now we can start. Now we are going to start by making slip knot. Then chain of 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. Slip stitch in first chain stitch to form a ring. And we are going to start first round. Chain of 3 as a first double crochet. And then in our circle we have to make another 23 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And we have to continue until we will have 23 double crochets plus chain 3, so in total 24. At the end of our round we have to work slip stitch in our top of chain 3, so maybe I'm going to show you. So after 23rd double crochet we have to make slip stitch into the third chain stitch. And now we are going to start the second round, chain of 3 as a first double crochet. Then chain 1 as a chain 1 space. In next double crochet we have to work another double crochet, then chain 1 as a chain 1 space, double crochet in next double crochet, chain 1 as a chain 1 space. So the same pattern now we have to continue all the way around. Double crochet, chain 1, then double crochet in next double crochet, and then chain 1. So at the end we should have 24 double crochets and 21 chain stitches. At the end again we have to work slip stitch into the third chain from the beginning. So now we've got round number 3. After slip stitch into the top of chain 3 we are going to start by making chain 3 as a first double crochet again, then chain of 2 as a chain 2 space. Double crochet in next double crochet, then chain 2, double crochet, next double crochet, chain 2, and the same pattern now We need to repeat all the way around, so at the end we should have 24 double crochets again and 24 chain 2 spaces. So to close our round we have to work slip stitch in third chain stitch from the beginning. Round number 4. We are going to start by making chain of 3 as a first double crochet and now into the same stitch we have to work one more double crochet. Chain 2, then 2 double crochets in next stitch, 1 and 2, chain of 2 and 2 double crochets in next stitch, 1 and 2, chain of 2, 2 double crochets in next stitch and this is our whole pattern. So in each double crochet from the previous round we have to work 2 double crochets and then chain of 2. So at the end we should have 24 groups of 2 double crochets and 24 chain 2 spaces. Round number 5. Again, we have to start by making chain of 3 as the first double crochet, then in next stitch 1 double crochet again. Chain of 2, then 1 double crochet in next 2 stitches, 1 and 2, chain 2, 1 double crochet in next 2 stitches, 1 and 2, chain of 2. So now in exactly the same way as we've done in our previous round we should have 24 groups of 2 double crochets and 24 chain 2 spaces. Round number 6. Again, chain of 3 as the first double crochet, then in next stitch we have to make 2 double crochets, 1 and 2. Chain of 2, 1 double crochet in first double crochet, then 2 double crochets in next one, 1 and 2. Chain of 2, 1 double crochet in first stitch and then 2 double crochets in second. So the same pattern, now we have to repeat all the way around. At the end we should have 24 groups of 3 double crochets and 24 chain 2 spaces. Now we are going to start round number 7 and now we need to make chain of 2 instead of the first part of the double crochet, then into the next 2 stitches we need to make 2 double crochets together. So we are working only through first 2 loops, last loop need to stay on the hook and in next stitch again. When we've got 3 loops we can finish the stitch and now chain of 4. In next 3 stitches, 3 double crochets together. So through first 2 loops, last loop need to stay on the hook. 1, 2 and 3. 4 loops, now we can finish the stitch, chain 4. In next 3 stitches, again, 3 double crochets together. 1, 2 and 3. 4 loops, we can finish the stitch, chain of 4. And the same pattern now we have to continue all the way around. At the end we have to work slip stitch in our two double crochets together. So chain 2 we need to skip and we can easily find the big stitch at the top. Round number 8. We are going to start by making chain 1, so after a slip stitch on the top of 2 double crochets together, we have to work 1 single crochet in exactly the same stitch. In chain 4 space, now we need to make 5 single crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Single crochet on the top of 3 double crochets together. And another 5 single crochets in next chain 4 space. 1, two, three, four, and five. Single crochet on the top of three double crochets together. Now again, five single crochets in next chain four, one, two, three, four, and five. Then single crochet on the top of three double crochets together. And the same pattern, now we have to continue all the way around. Now we are going to start round number 9. After slip stitch in our single crochet on the top of two double crochets together, now we have to make chain of 4 as the first treble crochet. Then chain of 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 as a chain 5 space, and one more treble crochet in the same single crochet, in the same stitch. And now we need to skip all single crochets, next 5 single crochets as we've done in chain 4, and we are going to the single crochet as we've done on the top of the next group of 3 double crochets together. And we need to make treble crochet, chain 5 again, and one more treble crochet. Then again, we have to skip 5 single crochets in 6th one, so on the top of the next group of 3 double crochets together, another treble crochet, chain 5, and another treble crochet. The same pattern now we need to repeat all the way around, so on the top of each 3 double crochets together, basically in that single crochet on the top of each group, we have to work some kind of V-stitch, so treble crochet, chain 5, and treble crochet. At the end, we have to finish our round by making slip stitch into the 4th chain from the bottom, so on the top of our first treble crochet. Now we are going to start round number 10, and now we have to work in exactly opposite side as we've done with our previous one. So we need to start by making chain of 4 as the first treble crochet, but now we are going directly to the next treble crochet, so chain 5 space we have to skip, and we need to make another treble crochet. So as you can see, now we've got triangle to the top and we had triangle to the bottom. And now after two treble crochets, chain of 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. In our previous round we had chain 5 between two, and now we've got chain 5 after two treble crochets. And now treble crochet in next treble crochet, then treble crochet in next treble crochet again. So again we have to skip chain 5 space, chain of 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and again treble crochet in next treble crochet, then treble crochet in next treble crochet, chain of 5. So the same pattern now we are going to continue all the way around. So we have to each time skip chain 5 spaces, work 2 treble crochets, and after each group of 2 treble crochets we have to work another chain 5. So one more time, treble crochet in next treble crochet, skip chain 5 space, and treble crochet in next one. So now chain 5 space we have to make between 2 treble crochets from our previous row, previous round. Now we've got round 11. So after slip stitch in our first treble crochet, so on the top of chain 4, we need to work chain 1, then single crochet in the same stitch, so we are in our first treble crochet. Now chain of 3, then single crochet in next treble crochet, and in chain 5 space 6 single crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And again, single crochet in first treble crochet, chain 3, single crochet in next treble crochet, and 6 single crochets in next chain 5 space. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Single crochet in next treble crochet, chain 3, single crochet in second one. And again, 6 single crochets in chain 5 space. So now the same pattern, we need to continue all the way around. So each time in a chain 5 space we have to make 6 single crochets, then single crochet in first treble crochet, chain 3, and single crochet in second treble crochets. So just at the top of our triangle we have to work chain 3 spaces. Now we've got round 12, and after slip stitch number first single crochet, now we have to make slip stitch in chain 3, then chain 1 and single crochet. Our round after single crochet, we are going to start by making 16 chain stitches. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. And now into the 12th chain from the hook, or into the 5th from the bottom, 1, 2, 3, 4, and into the 5th, we have to work slip stitch. So we should have 4 chain stitches before the slip stitch. Now chain of 4, single crochet in chain 3 space. Chain of 11, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and 11. Then single crochet in next chain 3. Chain of 16, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, and 16. And we have to count again, 1, 2, 3, 4, so into the 5th slip stitch, then chain of 4, and single crochet in next chain 3, chain of 11, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and 11, then single crochet in next chain 3 space. And this is our whole pattern. One time we have to work chain 16 slip stitch, and then chain 4, and then chain of 11. Now we are going to start round number 13. And after my last chain of 11, I've done slip stitch in single crochet, then I decided that in this round I'm going to change the color. So if you would like to change the color as well, just make slip stitch into the, or join with the next color into the chain for space before our big loop. So I will make little knot. If you are working with the same color, just make slip stitch after slip stitch into the single crochet. And now we are going to start by making chain 1, then 5 single crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Now into the center of our loop we are going to make 16 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, and 16. So now we've got 16 double crochets. In next chain for space, another 5 single crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Now into the chain 11, we are going to make 13 single crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, and 13. We can add extra 2 to make sure that we haven't got any gaps between single crochets, and then in next chain for space another 5 single crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And we've got another loop. 16 double crochets again. So in each loop all the way around we have to work 16 double crochets. In each chain for space before and after our loop, 5 single crochets, and in chain 11 we can work even 15 single crochets. So it's going to be look like this. The number of single crochets actually is not completely Now we are going to start round 14. After slip stitch in our first single crochet, now we need to work slip stitch in next 4 single crochets. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Then slip stitch into the next 3 double crochets. 1, 2, and 3. So we are going to start from the third double crochet, and now we have to make chain of 3. So as a first double crochet, then chain 1 as a chain 1 space. Now double crochet in next double crochet, chain 1, double crochet in next double crochet, chain 1, double crochet in next double crochet, chain 1, then into the next one, chain 1. And basically now we've got 5 double crochets, so we have to make another 7, and after each one chain 1 space. So we've got 2, 4, 6, 7, eight, nine, 10, 11, and this is the last one, the 12th one. So first two and the last two double crochets we have to skip. And now, instead of chain of 1, we need to make chain of 3. Then we are going to the 7th single crochet. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7th. And we have to work single crochet in 7th, in 8th, and into the 9th as well. So we've got 3 single crochets, chain of 3, and again we have to skip another 6 single crochets in this part, 5 single crochets in next part, another 2 double crochets, and we have to work double crochet into the third double crochet, and we are going to continue what we've done at the beginning of our round. So double crochet, chain one, double crochet, chain one, double crochet, chain one, and now we have to make one double crochet in first in next 9 double crochets. So we need to make again 12 double crochets and 11 chain one spaces. Then chain three, 3 single crochets, another chain 3, and this pattern we need to repeat all the way around. Now we are going to start round 15, yes. And we need to make slip stitch in, after slip stitch in first double crochet, now we have to work slip stitch in chain 1 space, then slip stitch in next double crochet and in chain 1 space again. Then chain of 3 as a first double crochet, so we are going to start from the second chain space and then chain 1. Double crochet in next stitch, chain 1, double crochet in next stitch, chain 1, then double crochet in next stitch, chain 1, in next one, chain 1, in next, chain 1. So we should have 9 double crochets and 8 chain 1 spaces, because the last chain 1 space we need to skip as well. Two, four, six, eight, nine. So as I said, the last chain space we have to skip, then chain three, 3 single crochets, chain three, and the first chain one space we need to skip as well. We are going directly to the second chain one space. Double crochet, then chain one, and double crochet in next. Chain one, double crochet in next, chain one, double crochet in next. So the same pattern, now we have to continue in each part. So we should have 9 double crochets and chain 1 spaces, and between each part we are not working with chain stitches at all. Now we are going to start row 16. After slip stitch on the top of chain 3, now we have to work slip stitch in chain 1 space, and we need to make chain of 3 as a first double crochet, then chain, double crochet in next double crochet, chain 2, double crochet in next double crochet, chain 2, in fourth chain space we have to work double crochet, chain 2, and another double crochet. Into the fifth, exactly the same, but now chain of 2, then double crochet in fifth chain 1 space, chain 2, and one more double crochet. So into the center, into the two center chain spaces, we have to work some kind of V-stitch. Double crochet, chain 2, double crochet, in next one again, but after each double crochet always we have to work chain 2 space. So now chain of 2, double crochet in next chain space, chain 2, double crochet in next chain space, chain 2, and double crochet in next chain space. So in first 3 chain spaces and in the last 3 chain spaces we are working only with one double crochet. Now we have to go directly without any chain spaces to the next chain 1, and we need to repeat. So double crochet in first one, chain 2, double crochet in second one, chain 2, double crochet in third, chain 2, then into the fourth double crochet, chain 2, and one more double crochet, chain 2 again, and into the fifth again double crochet, chain 2, and double crochet, chain of 2, and in our last 3 chain spaces one double crochet, and then chain 2, double crochet in next, chain 2, and double crochet in next. Now we are going directly to the next chain 1 space, and we have to repeat our pattern all the way around. So we should have 2, 4, 6, 8, 10 double crochets and 9 chain 2 spaces. Now we've got round 17 and we need to start by making slip stitch in first chain 2 space. So after slip stitch into the top of chain 3. Now we have to work chain of 5 as a first double treble crochet, then chain of 11. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 and 11. Now we are going to the center chain space, so between two V stitches, and we have to work two double crochets together. So through first two loops, one, then one more time, through first two loops. When we've got three loops, we can finish the stitch. Chain of 11, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 and 11. Then we are going directly to the last chain space and we have to make first three parts of the double treble crochet. 1, 2 and 3, and into the first chain space on the next part we have to work first three parts of the next double treble crochet. 2 and 3. When we've got three loops on the hook, we can finish the stitch and then chain of 11. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 and 11. And we need to repeat. So into the center chain space we have to make two double crochets together, so between two V stitches. 1 and 2, then chain of 11. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 and into the last chain 2 space we have to work first 3 parts, 1, 2 and 3, then in next one again, 1, 2 and 3. 3 loops we can finish the stitch and again chain of 11. Into the center chain 2 space, 2 double crochets together, chain of 11 and another 2 double treble crochets together in last and first chain space. At the end of our round we have to make the first 3 parts of the last double treble crochet in our last chain space, and when we've got 2 loops on our hook, now we can make slip stitch into the 5th chain. So on the top of the first double treble crochet. So we need to pull the yarn through our 2 loops. And now we can fasten off and cut the yarn. In next round I'm going to change the yarn color again.